backstage in the VIP tent at Stoke 2012 live for Signal 1 with Skepta.
I just heard how many people are out there in the crowd and I've got a bit of butterflies, but I need to have a drink.
Do you still get nervous?
Very nervous.
You look so chilled.
No, do you know what it is for me? When I get side stage and I've got the mic and they say, anyone in 1 minute? That's when it all starts. That's when it all, the butterflies, they get crazy.
Look, if you want me to stay on stage and do some grind, mate, I'm down with that.
Mate, no,
peace,
not
war, I can
right.
do this.
I'll be all right.
They're going absolutely mental out there for you. We're sort of teasing the artists that are coming up, and the minute I say Skepta, they just go sick.
Man, do you know what? I haven't done a show up here for a little while. I was on tour, but it was more close-knit. But to do a show with that much people out there, I don't know. I can't wait. I'm looking forward to it at the same time as I'm nervous.
Now, last time you were on my Signal 1 Total Access show, we got off to a rocky start because I dared suggest that you shave your chest.
No. I don't shave it. I'm one of the lucky people that did. I don't really get a hairy chest that much.
Mine's horrifically hairy. Mine's really hairy, mate. I don't normally show men my chest, but you can tell.
No. I'm alright.
You've been absolutely smashing it. We've been playing Make Peace Not War a lot.
Thank you very
and
much.
Things are going really well,
thank
aren't
you,
they?
Thank you. Yeah. First of all, I want to send a big shout out to all the DJs that I've been supporting, because you know my music is kind of very niche. You know, I mean, some people get it, some people don't, and all the DJs that play it, nothing but love to them all, and all the supporters that buy my music, thank you very much. Respect.
My mate Alex was buzzing because he asked me when I first played Make Peace Not War. Hey, is it Make Love Not War?
Make Peace Not War.
Make Peace Not War, getting it right. He asked me if you'd gone away from grime. And I asked you this in the interview, you corrected saying, get the album, if you want the grime, it's full of it.
You know what it is? It just, this is the UK, there's a lot of people here, different kind of genres of music, and at the end of the day, I produced the track. It wasn't like somebody sent me the beat and I just did it because I thought it was going to work. I made it because I liked it, do you know what I mean? And I make all different kinds of music, but I know that grime is my home genre, do you know what I mean? And when you get my album, when it comes out at the end of summer, you'll see that, you know.
You're still a bad boy.
Cream of the crop.
You're still a bad boy as well.
Boy, yeah.
I noticed that your Too Many Men tune has clocked up over 3.5 million views.
And I'll never understand how. I made that song about 5 years ago. And I don't. And some songs, sometimes you just make them out of fun and you realise that fun, it travels to the fans and the supporters and they understand everything about it, and it's been one of my longest lasting songs that I've ever made in my whole career.
When you make a tune and then you're walking through a city on a night out or something and you hear one of your tunes playing out of a bar or on holiday, how does it feel?
Man, I don't know, man. It's good to know that people are playing it without you even being there. Do you know what I mean? Like, they don't need to be there.
You could be playing somewhere in the world right now.
Yeah, you can be, like, they play it. You know, it's got played all over Nigeria. It gets played in Dubai, Egypt. I've been heard it's been playing in America. You know, it's just one of those songs that, you know, we need some more girls in here. I'm sure that everybody across the world thinks that when they walk into a club one time. So
definitely.
Everybody got it, man. I love it.
There's more chance of pulling then as well.
I love it.
What are you going to be like on stage?
You know what, with me it is, it's just like energy tennis. If I get really hype and the crowd get even more hype, I get even more, and you just keep going back and forth and just bounce off each other. And I'm just going to give, you know, I know, like I said, some people get my music, some people don't, but I want to not think about the people that don't. The people that actually came here to see me today, I want to make sure they know they've seen Skepta at his best on stage today and just give them a massive show.
They're going to love you. Is there anything they can do in the audience to sort of make you buzz? Just get that high energy up and sing back.
I want them to basically sing as loud as they can. That is the best thing, because I don't write lyrics on paper. It's all really done in my head and stuff. And when I go to shows and people are singing lyrics I wrote in my bedroom, I feel like this is sick. You know what I mean? So just be really energetic. Use all the energy that you've got today and just use it on my set today. It's going to be amazing.
Skepta, you're going to rock it. Have an amazing
Thank
time at 2012 Live, bro.
Thank you
very much.
Nice one.